We particularly welcome guests and visitors who might be here with us. Are there any guests or visitors who would like to introduce themselves or be introduced? Oh, we got one over here. Yes. Welcome. Always nice to have a visitor in the choir. You've been here a couple times, I thought. Yeah. Oh, good to have you back.
What's your last name? Hubbard.
Right.
Hubbard?
Yeah.
This is Miles Hubbard visiting us for the first time from Morgan Hill.
Welcome, Miles. Good to have you here. We invite you all to sign this little red booklet at the end of your row and let us know of your presence, any details you want to share with us, any questions you might have. Several announcements today. First, we welcome Ernest and Tori Little. Ernest is old third. He's been here before, I guess, but not when I've been here. So Ernest is from Canada and his wife, Tori. And I particularly welcome both of them. It's good to have you here. I performed their wedding ceremony a few months back, so nice to see you again. Welcome. Thank you. I wanted to notice, you know, in the order of worship, the first hymn, note we're only singing one verse. Each week now during Advent, we will add a verse to continue in that Advent journey. I would call your attention to the announcements and the calendar as well. Lots of activities coming up, lots of announcements, particularly the Wednesday night study. If you'd like to come to the study, we hope you can. I'm looking forward to that, a time of Bible study and fellowship, informal. We'll gather at 5:30 in the multipurpose room. We'll eat at about 6, and then the study will start about 6:40. So come any time in there. The first half hour is mostly just to relax and hang out. So we hope you can come and be a part of that. If you know you're coming, and you can fill out that little tear out at the bottom of the last page and drop it in the offering. Let us know what you might bring and who all is coming, just to give our host some idea of the count. And you can drop that in the offering plate, and we'll get that to the Floors and the Millers. Or hand it to them, either one. But even if you don't fill it out and you want to come, just show up, that's great too. Are there other, I know, I want to thank the worship team for all this that we have here at the decorations, and also thank Barb for the cover art on the bulletin. You'll see these through the Advent season. Thank you again for that. Nice to have that. Coffee hour will be in there, right?
So, yeah.
Coffee hour is going to be inside. Yeah. And all the food is going to sit on that side of the door. So, but it's going to be warm. And yeah.
So this Saturday is our annual community dinner that we do for the community to bring them in and give them a nice warm meal for the holidays. There are sign-up sheets on the little blue table outside there. There's still lots of slots, so please put your name on one of them. We especially need people to either donate money for a turkey to be cooked or cook a turkey and bring it. And easy things are like cans of yams, and you can get mashed potatoes at Costco frozen. I hear they're really good, so if you don't want to peel all those potatoes, just go to Costco and get some frozen potatoes, cranberry sauce. So there's simple stuff, and the turkeys are probably our stuffing. So 11 o'clock, we will be here at the church. So if you're bringing food, please try to get it here between 11 and 12. The actual dinner starts at 1 o'clock. We always welcome volunteers to help serve the meal. And it's fun to socialize with all our guests. And I looked at the list, and we have almost 50 people signed up. So it's a big year this year. So we can use lots of help. And you get to eat, too. So, and we have gifts for the kids and gift cards for the families. And so it's an event that the people around this area really enjoy. So come help us sign up. And if you want to bring the food, like canned foods during the week, Chris, you'll be here from Tuesday to Friday if you drop it off too. So thank you.
Any other announcements? One more thing I was going to do here, but were there any other announcements? Okay, notice the Advent candle lighting is a little bit different this year, I guess, because I've changed it slightly, and we have a song in the middle. And I've asked the choir if they would teach it to us now, for when we're going to sing it in a minute.
Number 92. Instead, Advent makes the bold pronouncement that
Though darkness surrounds us, the God of Torah and the prophets is not done. Advent plays the long game. It waits, like spectators at a close ball game, for the next breakthrough, the next movement, the next flurry of action on the scene. Its words of longing, impatience, pleading, reveal our undergirding conviction that there is God, and this God is not relegated to the confines of history. Let us continue our Advent journey this morning.
Today, we begin our Advent journey. The lights of these candles light our way and help us to prepare our hearts and minds for the coming of God's Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. We live in hope as we watch for God's coming among us. Today, we light the first candle of our Advent. This is the candle of hope.
Jesus, our Lord, we thank you. that breaks into our world in surprising times and places.
Love you, God.
We give thanks for your coming into our world and our lives.
Light our hearts this Advent season, that we may journey in hope and faithfulness.
Present and ready, awake and alert to your coming into the world.